Jess. Jess Black. Find me at the...
Lord knows everyone could use a drink.
I could use a hand, and I can pay. I swore I'd find it, and I will. Are you here about the job? So, here's the deal. In the days of way back, my family ran a distillery. They made the best damn drink you've ever tasted. McKellen 57. But the place went bankrupt and everything vanished. Except, I found my great-grandpa's journal, and it says they were aging the whiskey underwater all over the county. There's barrels that were never found. I've been tracking them down for years. I'll pay you a finder's fee if you bring me all of them. I'm pretty sure there's one in the lake out back. There's a marker just east of here. She flies. People can't fly.
Jess.
Thank you. beggars are busy harvesting flowers. I think they're using them to make drugs.
Eli's got some conservation woman working on how to handle the judges. Haven't heard from her in a while. You should probably go and see how she's doing.
Got reports that Drubman repelled another Peggy attack. We should head over, make sure they don't need anything.
The Persians, the Romans, the Caliphate, the Mongols, the Babylonians, all of them gone. What have we learned? Empires always crumble. This is our final warning. This is our final collapse. We must prepare for what comes next. We must prepare for the new Eden. Know your purpose. Do what needs to be done. Sacrifice. And when the moment finally comes, we will be ready. Mother Nature doesn't care who you are or where you came from. She eliminates without conscience and empathy. Only the strong survive. Or so it used to be. Scientists have manipulated nature for ages, but they've done it all wrong. They've made us soft. They've made us complacent. They've made us sick. But when the farmer breeds his animals, he segregates them according to their traits. He discards the diseased and the inferior and the weak. He acts without conscience or empathy. We are like the farmer. We call the herd. Our time is near. This is no accident. This is no surprise. We have been warned throughout history. The Persians, the Romans, the Caliphate, the Mongols, the Babylonians, all of them gone. What have we learned? Empires always crumble. This is our final warning. This is our final collapse. We must prepare for what comes next. We must prepare for the new Eden. Know your purpose. Do what needs to be done. Sacrifice. And when the moment finally comes, we'll be ready. Mother Nature doesn't care who you are or where you came from. She eliminates without conscience and empathy. Only the strong survive. Scientists have manipulated nature for ages, but they've done it all wrong. They've made us soft. They've made us complacent. They've made us sick. But when the farmer breeds his animals, he segregates them according to their traits. He discards the diseased and the inferior and the weak. He acts without conscience or empathy. We are like the farmer. We call the herd. Empires always crumble. This is our final warning. This is our final collapse. We must prepare for what comes next. We must prepare for the new Eden. Know your purpose. finally comes, we will be ready. Mother Nature doesn't care who you are or where you came from. She eliminates without conscience and empathy. Only the strong survive, or so it used to be. Scientists have manipulated nature for ages.
Thank you. kid. I can't believe those fuckers were keeping folks prisoners there, waiting for their indoctrination. Thanks for springing Jess. That niece of mine is as tough as nails, but she's got a knack for trouble. Check in on her for me, would you?
Thank God we saved all those people.
I doubt this place will ever get back to full up.
Did you hear all that gunfire? Came from the Elliott house. Let's go check it out.
Good thing we got here when we did. These poor people weren't gonna last much longer.
You sure as hell know how to handle yourself. Thanks for busting me out. Name's Jess. If you're out here picking fights with the cult, then I'm guessing you already know my Uncle Dutch. Look, I don't got a lot of time to waste. I'm gonna get right to the point. I was on the trail of one of Jacob's zealots. Goes by the name The Cook. Yeah, don't sound so scary. But believe me, he's one twisted fuck. Almost tracked him down. But a Peggy patrol got the drop on me. I need your help. We can't let this trail go cold. If you're looking to hook up with the Whitetails, this could be your way in. And more importantly, you'd help put an evil motherfucker in the grave. Gotta move. Wasted too much time already. Follow me. This way. See that? That's his calling card. Innocent people burned alive. Goddamn cults grabbing everyone. They'll take you from your home, the bar, even church. Don't matter where you are. Then they slot you into one of two categories. Weak or strong. See, anyone who can't or won't fight for him winds up dead. Culling the herd, he calls it. Wholesale slaughter innocent people. Nobody believed it was happening because nobody wanted to believe. then there's the one we're after.
The
cook. He's one of Jacob's favorites. The one who leads his purge. Just bought into all shit.
You're gonna die!
Colt up ahead.
What the... Let's have a look. Careful. Stay low. Shit, I don't see him anywhere. Got some people locked up, though. Treats people like fucking animals. Keeping them in cages. Okay, let's do this. But keep your head down. If they spot us, those hostages are dead.
Something more important. We'll make you believe. We'll make you strong. To be honest, I just feel sorry for him. Promising souls is dirty work.
Others. They picked them up the mountain.
Freeze out. They're gonna kill us.
There's fire everywhere!
I'll kill you for that.
Fire! It's spreading!
The cook. He took others. Okay, let's get them out.
You wanna know why they call him the cook? A couple years back, Jacob sent one of his guys out to round up this family. Parents and kids.
First thing he did was starve them. Gave him nothing.
Not even a drop of water. After 3 days, they got so thirsty they had to drink their own piss. But the kids didn't want to do it.
So the parents forced it down their throats.
Kids puked it right back up. Cook didn't like that.
The cult's judges are a world of trouble. They either kill people, or they pull everyone they find behind enemy lines. It's gotta stop.
You're not a Peggy, but you sure ain't no whitetail.
Well, they won't try that again.
Thank you. Oh, God. The cook took the rest of the pit.
Please don't leave me here.
Thank you for saving my ass.
Let's go.
You're the one that's trying to poke the hornet's nest, aren't you?
Hey, quick question.
Those judges out there are fucking beasts. They caught this guy and practically tore him apart.
Decided to keep the kids like a little warmer yourself.
And then he asked if they were hungry. Kids were starving, so they said yes. Started begging for food. Cook asked if they want pork. Kids said yes. So he went out to the parents and took their shoes off and started to play. This little piggy went to market. And the blood poured like a damned faucet. Cook had a big old grin on his face as he offered each little piece to the kids.
Piggy's left.
So he laughed and set the parents on fire. And the air filled up with that sickly sweet smell of roasting flesh. I'll never forget that smell. When they finally stopped screaming, I looked around and he was just gone. Vanished like some sort of demon in the night. Anyways, that's why they call him the cook.
Better death than that piece of shit deserved.
thought I'd feel better. Dutch was right. Cook's dead and I don't feel anything. All I ever wanted was to find this guy. And now I don't know what I'm supposed to do. Dutch has been right about a lot of shit lately. Colt, Eli, maybe he's right about you too. You need someone to watch your back? Call me. And, thanks for everything you've done. What up, sister? Bugs can fuck right off.
You
did good here.
Saved a lot of people. Thanks. Thing is, I know these fuckers. They're like clockwork. The trucks they send to pick up the next bunch of recruits are already on their way. I want to set up a little welcome party when they come through the front gates. We're gonna blow those trucks sky high so they'll never use them again. Whatever we do, can't let them get away. We gotta get ready.
Morale is not great among the Whitetails. Too many have been taken recently.
Good thing you came along when you did. I don't think these people would have laughed at me.
I feel badly for those poor wolves.
Not today, fuckwads.
gonna take more than a little love to bring this place back up to spec.
On the road. I'll do the rest.
You kept this place in the right hands. Thanks.
Can't stand what they do to their prisoners. It makes me want to puke.
It's gonna take a lot of work to clean this place up.
Gun it.
I'm fine.
Move it! What?
You're good. You're lucky you got me.
Sure glad you're here.